There is a playback toolbar that you can use to do more or less an instant replay of any process data that you've got stored. So for example, if I go into, let's go into this batch reactor here, I'm going to bring up this option called Toolbar Manager. This is where we found our, this is the browser toolbar. You'll also find this replay toolbar, or the playback toolbar, I should say. And within this, what I can do is I can specify, well, I can do many things. I can use this start time and end time here to actually control what I see as the start and end time. There we go. And I can specify my options in here. Right now I'm looking at a period of time that presumably is of great interest to you. Let's say this is, you know, this is the day the chlorine gas wafted out where it wasn't supposed to, and everybody's trying to figure out who to blame. So you zero in on this time and you say, well, I would like to see a replay of this at 10-minute intervals. By default, this is going to be looking at a lot more data than just this one day. So you need to go in there and specify what period you're interested in. In this case, let's go with, let's go back August, say, of 2009. We'll go from the 18th for the start time to the 19th for the end time. And what I'd like to do, well, let's see if we can't, let's see if we can't play this back at a rate of, I think the default here is 5 seconds. Let's go with 1 second, and we're going to be at 10-minute intervals. So when I click on OK, and I go ahead and play this back, what you'll notice is this is showing me a replay of all the dynamic objects on here. Now let's make this a little bit bigger so that we can see it a little better. You see the dynamic objects are changing. We're essentially watching this in real time. You can't see it, but let me go ahead and pause this. If I were to go in here in build mode, and let's just make the, let's just make the font a little bit smaller here. Let's go with 8-point font. There we go. By making that font smaller, now when I replay this, we should be able to see this is incrementing in 10-minute intervals. There we go. Once a second. And all of these are incrementing. Now maybe it's belaboring the obvious, but let's go in here in build mode. I'll go ahead and stop my replay. And I'll add the timestamp at the bottom. Position that a little better. We'll go ahead and resume the replay. Yeah, we're seeing those 10-minute intervals we were talking about. So this is this nice new replay bar. When I'm finished with that, I can also use this to pick it up and move it around as I choose. I can go back. Let's go to a larger span of time here. Let's go from August all the way to the current time. And that's in June. We'll go June 23rd. And now, if I were to pick this up and move it around, as you can see, yeah, there we go, I'm seeing much larger groups of data. And I can use this to zoom in or zoom out. There we go. So that's controlled by what options you've set up here. Let's go with, say, May to June. There we go. And that gives us just yet one more way of looking at this in more detail. Now, so far we've been concentrating on the automated replay, but in addition to the automated, of course, you could, if you're interested, let me zoom in here, you can use this to go through this manually. And as I mentioned before, all the elements on this display are changing in response to what you've done with this, the playback toolbar.